Hello, you're watching Proactive London. KEFI Gold and Copper says the development of its Tulu Kapi gold project in Ethiopia has restarted after being postponed for 5 months due to security concerns in that country. Joining with more is Executive Chairman Harry Adams. Harry, it's good to speak with you today.
Good. Nice to be here. Thank you.
So, Harry, you're actually in Addis Ababa at the moment, where there has been a civil war in the country. Are you comfortable now that the situation on the ground has abated enough to resume the project?
Yeah, so you could say we had a very challenging few years, but it all peaked last year when the highly publicised civil war. It never came to Addis Ababa. It never came to our part of Ethiopia. But there were some shockwaves and some particular incidents that did affect us. So we did suspend as a precautionary measure before bringing hundreds of millions of dollars and hundreds of people to our site. But it is all over. Yes, it's. I've been here for nearly all of the last year, most of it continuously. So I speak from personal observation, and all the major world powers are behind the outcome of what happened here, and it's all history now. You'd be quite surprised, really, how calm and positive things are. I think the sense of relief and sense of needing to get the development show back on the road. One of the top 10 growth countries in the world for 20 years, it stalled, and now it has to get it back going again.
So what's the first step as you resume the project, Harry?
Well, we spelt out in an RNS this morning that it's really a sort of a stretched project launch quite deliberately. It's February to May staged launch, culminating in a full launch, obviously, at the end of that process. But we think it's important to be on the ground and building up activities and demonstrating to ourselves and to our syndicate partners and to and the community itself that everything's building up very smoothly and supportively. And in fact, we got messages today from the community asking us to move a bit faster. They're very keen for this thing to get going. So a staged launch over some months. And that's where we should have been last year. But there you are, in a sense, good thing we weren't there last year and then have to stall. In a sense, best that it's all peaked and passed, all settled down, and now we can confidently go forward.
Has the capital estimate for the project changed due to the delay, Harry?
The capital estimate overall is the same as we published around August last year. We did publish an increase last year because of the industry taking off internationally, prices tightening for capital equipment and so on. But we covered that off. We have to confirm all this, of course, again. But as best we can judge, we're there or thereabouts in our estimates. And the contractors have been started on their process, which takes 6 to 8 weeks. To re-verify all their costings and schedules to make absolutely sure they can sell on the bottom line for full construction. But we're there or thereabouts, so what we've said publicly.
So when would you expect those final costings from the principal contractors?
Well, we've given them, they've asked for and we've given them 6 to 8 weeks, so let's call it the end of April.
Okay. And of course, that's not the only good news you have at the moment, because it coincides with the takeoff of your projects in Saudi Arabia. So you're going to have boots on the ground all over.
Well, it sort of feels hard to believe because we've been under pressure for so long on the defense, as I call it. That feels quite remarkable now, really, instead of having one project in one country sort of struggling to get going, and now finally the country having turned, we can get it going, which is, fantastic of itself. But the fact of the matter is that coinciding with that is that in Saudi Arabia, the regulatory, slowdowns and obstacles that we've lived with for some years have been removed by a very, very far-reaching regulatory overhaul. and we've been granted licenses, been told that our mining license application for one project will be dealt with very shortly. So it's sort of both countries turning on for us at the same time. So we're no longer a one project, one country thing. We're actually a three project in two countries with both jurisdictions actually going sort of pedal to the metal. You know, they're both pushing us and they're both conducive to actually getting going. So we're adjusting very quickly with new people on the ground and all sorts of things happening really to adjust to a completely different posture and a completely different opportunity to grab it, so to speak, while it's hot and get going.
So what sort of news flow should investors be looking out for in the short term, Harry?
Well, compare the news flow of three projects on the go in two positive situations with the news flow of one project on the go in one situation that wasn't positive, and doesn't take much to work out. There'll be quite a flurry of things to report on, from month to month as things keep moving on all three projects.
Well, I hope you'll keep us updated on any new developments, but thank you very much for the update today.
Yeah, it's a pleasure. Thanks very much.
Harry Adams is the Executive Chairman of KEFI Gold and Copper.